Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. I am the Lord who saves and heals. I am the Lord who saves and heals. I am the Lord who saves and heals. In you, O Lord, I put my trust. In you, O Lord, I put my trust. In you, O Lord, I put my trust. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God.
Happy New Year 2024, and welcome to Taunton Deane and South Sedgemoor Circuit online service. We are happy to say, at the start of the new year, as Methodists, we make a distinctive resolution to have a covenant service, often celebrated on the first Sunday of the year. It is at the heart of Methodist devotion and discipleship, and our dedication in working for social justice. We joyfully celebrate God's gracious offer. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. So my call to worship today is from Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, all heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord over many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon speak like a calf, the Sharon like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth and strips the forest bare, and his temple all cry glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as King forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. This is all what we need as we begin this year. And so All the hymns that we shall be blessed with have been carefully selected and given to us with permission. So we thank all those who put all this together for us. And so our first hymn is Morning Has Broken Like the First Morning. If you have the Singing the Faith hymn book, it's 136. Let us sing together.
Morning has broken like the first morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them spring.
Let us pray. Glory to the Father, the God of love, who created us, who continually preserves and sustains us, who has loved us with an everlasting love and given us the light of the knowledge of his glory in the face of Jesus Christ. Glory to Jesus Christ, our Savior, who, though he was rich, yet for our sake became poor, and was tested in every way as we are, yet without sin, who proclaimed the good news of the kingdom and was obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross, and was raised from the dead and is alive forever, and has opened the kingdom of heaven to all who trust in him, who is seated at God's right hand in glory, and he will come to be our judge. Blessed be God forever. Glory to the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, by whom we are born into the family of God and members of the body of Christ, whose witness confirms us, whose wisdom teaches us, whose power enables us, who will do for us more than we can ask or think. Blessed be God forever. To the one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, praise be and glory forever. Amen. And so I will take us through today's reading from Mark chapter 1, verse 4 to 11. John appeared baptizing in the wilderness and proclaiming a baptism of repentance and for forgiveness of sins. And all the country of Judea and Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and wore a leather belt around his waist and ate locusts and wild honey. And he preached, saying, "After me comes he who is mightier than I, the strap of whose sandals I'm not even worthy to stoop down and untie. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." Thanks be to God. And so we shall sing again as we ponder on these words and think about the covenant that we shall be taking today. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. This is found in Singing the Faith 395. We sing together.
Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Break me, melt me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Break me, melt me.
Acknowledge from the Methodist resources, I will share some words within my reflection. When we come to this service of the covenant, what God offers is a loving relationship. The covenant is not a contract in which God and human beings agree to provide any particular goods and services for each other. It is not something that we have to do to create a relationship with God. God has freely and graciously already made it possible. Rather, the covenant is the means of grace by which we accept the relationship and then seek to sustain it. It is therefore not so much about getting into a relationship with God as it is about staying in it. It is not about acquiring a relationship with God, but living within a loving relationship that God has already offered us. God's gracious offer to us is therefore simultaneously a challenge. If God has committed to us, are we prepared to accept that as a reality and commit ourselves in return to God? Even if we do choose to accept it, how can we manage to live out our commitment adequately, frail and human as we are? Think about it. Now, as we go back to the gospel that I read, There is no word in the Gospel of Mark about the birth or youth of Jesus. He starts right in it with the good news of Jesus' baptism as the beginning of his ministry. It is the fulfillment of the messenger promised by Prophet Isaiah, reading 40, verse 3, a promise echoed by John's own explanation of Jesus' baptism, that his baptism was with water. But Jesus will baptize you and me with the Holy Spirit. John's baptism had two components, one of repentance and one of forgiveness. Our baptismal liturgy marks the end of old life. Do you renounce? And the beginning of a life lived in God's grace and forgiveness. Then John adds a new component with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and that is also in the baptism service. You have been sealed by the Holy Spirit. But most of us, unfortunately, don't even remember, because maybe like me, we were baptized when we were little babies. But thank God, in many of our services, we come to see how children are baptized. We hear the words again. So that means we really know all this that happens. Therefore, in baptism, we become part of Christ's body. Paul writes that for by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, 1 Corinthians 12:13. And that as many of you were baptized in Christ have put on Christ. That is also taken from Galatians chapter 3, verse 27. We often speak of baptism as a means of grace. This is one of the ways that God's grace comes to us. Physically, it's only a small splash of water, but it marks the beginning of a whole new life of forgiveness, of the presence of God's Spirit, of our union with Jesus, and our becoming part of the worldwide Christian church. Water is life. And without water, I'm sure we cannot really survive. Our bodies are full of water and our bodies need water. We need water to cook food, to drink, to keep ourselves fresh. We just need water in every sense of it. And also, when we think about it as Christians, let us also imagine that aspect of water in coming, that John translates it into the, you know, that Jesus Christ will baptize us with the Holy Spirit. And then let us think also about light that God first created. So I tell myself there are two very important things in this life: water and light. And so the Holy Spirit is something we don't see, but we do live within the guidance of the Holy Spirit as it was promised to us by Jesus Christ. And John Wesley, the founding father of Methodism, recognized that people needed not just to accept, but also to grow in relationship with God. He emphasized that God's grace and love constantly prompts and seeks to transform us. And so we should constantly seek and pray to grow in holiness and in love. The question, or rather the challenge I have been thinking about, is how much can we keep the renewing of this covenant to last through the whole year? Are your goals met? Do we go back and think about what we have done that we promised we will do with God's help? Or do we have to start all over again, year after year, making these promises? I don't know about you, but really making these vows is something that I deeply think of, challenge myself. Am I going to be this that I have claimed to be? And I think that is the reason we do have a covenant service every beginning of the year, so that we can keep ourselves deeply rooted in Christ and remind ourselves that this journey really is not easy, but with Christ, all is possible. So let us celebrate the Lord's doing, as I now invite you to enter into this covenant afresh. Sisters and brothers in Christ, let us again accept our place within this covenant which God has made with us and with all who are called to be Christ's disciples. This means that, by the help of the Holy Spirit, we accept God's purpose for us and the call to love and serve God in all our lives and work. Christ has many services to be done. Some are easy, others are difficult. Some bring honor, others bring reproach. Some are suitable to our natural inclinations and material interests. Others are contrary to both. In some, we may please Christ and please ourselves. In others, we cannot please Christ except by denying ourselves. Yet the power to do all these things is given to us in Christ, who strengthens us. Therefore, let us make this covenant of God our own. Let us give ourselves to Him, trusting in His promises and relying on His grace. Eternal God, in your faithful and enduring love, you call us to share in your gracious covenant in Jesus Christ. In obedience, we hear and accept your commands. In love, we seek to do your perfect will. And with joy, we offer ourselves anew to you. We are no longer ours, but yours. Let us together renew our covenant with God. I am no longer my own, but yours. Your will, not mine, be done in all things, wherever you may place me, in all that I do, in all that I may endure, when there is work for me and when there is none, when I'm troubled and when I'm at peace. Your will be done when I'm valued and when I am disregarded, when I find fulfillment and when it is lacking, when I have all things and when I have nothing. I willingly offer all I have and am to serve you as and where you choose. Glorious and blessed God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you are mine and I am yours. May it be so forever. Let this covenant now made on earth be fulfilled in heaven. And so I shall say a few more prayers. As we have entered this covenant, not ourselves alone, but as your servants and witnesses, let us pray for the church, for the world. Loving God, hear us as we pray for your holy Catholic Church. Make us all one, that the world may believe. Inspire and lead us and all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world. Establish justice and peace among all people, especially in places where there's a lot of trouble and unsettling, misery, homelessness, death, and all these things. Have compassion on all who suffer from any sickness, grief, or trouble. Deliver them from all their distress. We praise you for all your saints who have entered your glory. Bring us all to share in your heavenly kingdom. Let us pray in silence for all our needs and for those of others. Lord our God, you have helped us by your grace to make these prayers, and you have promised through Christ our Lord that when two or three agree in his name, you will grant what they ask. Answer now your servants' prayers according to their needs. In this world, grant that we may truly know you, and in the world to come, graciously give us eternal life through Christ Jesus our Father. Amen. As our Savior taught us, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And so now we shall sing our final hymn. There is a Redeemer, God's own Son, precious Lamb of God, Messiah, Holy One. Singing the Faith 338. We sing together.
Precious.
our final blessings. May the Lord, who established a covenant with those who seek to enter the kingdom, be always present with you. May Jesus Christ, who sealed the new covenant with his sacrifice on the cross, bring you peace. May the Holy Spirit of God guide your life now and forever. Go in peace to serve God and your neighbors in all that you do. Amen. Thank you for joining us. And once again, we wish you a blessed 2024. Thank you.
Be still for